Guruji, what caused man to seem to be separated from God in the first place? Who are we? Where did we come from? And why are we here?
What caused man to be separated from God in the first place is a total misconception fostered by so-called church organizations. But what makes a man feel that he's separated is because of a undeveloped consciousness or an undeveloped awareness where he does not seem to realize his real self. He finds himself separated because of all the problems he goes through, all the anxieties he has, and all the troubles that he might suffer. Then he says, "Is there really a God?" Questions that. If there was a God, which theologians call to be kind and compassionate Father, why should he be so unkind to people and make them suffer? Yet they do not seem to realize that divinity is a neutral energy, an all-pervading, all-permeating neutral energy, and it is you yourself that brings suffering upon yourself. How many times a day do you ever think that there is divinity? You don't. You'll rather think of the dinner you're going to cook, or the clothes you're going to wear, or the work you're going to do at the job at your work. But you don't think of divinity at all. The only time you think of God is when you are in trouble. You say, "Oh God, please help me." He won't. That's for sure. He will tell you, "Help yourself." And therefore the old saying that we know so well, God only helps those that help themselves. Now this really means that you are activating that divine energy to help yourself. 99.9% of the world's people always like to think of the dark side of things and never about the silver lining behind every cloud. They do not see the opportunity that lies in every adversity. And this very adversity that you are going through makes you feel you are separate from God, where in reality no separation has ever occurred. Divinity is said to be infinite and eternal, and so are you, infinite and eternal. Dropping one body and picking up the next body is like changing from one suit to the other. Yet that inner self forever remains in its own stillness. I do not believe in God. I don't. I know God. And that is what everyone must strive for, is to know God. And by knowing God, you'll find the living God, and not an abstract conception of some old man sitting on a throne somewhere up there. Through the process of evolution, from the primal atom which I spoke about, one goes through so many different experiences, and all these experiences goes into the memory bank which is in your mind. So we are living in obscurity and ignorance by denying the universality and the eternity of that which is. Through spiritual practices, you develop the sense of isness. I am that I am, Yahweh. You develop this sense of isness. And the more you develop the sense of isness, the more you will live a life of here and now, and not a life in the past or projected into the future. So, if your mind is continuously being conditioned to separation, then you can also recondition or repattern the mind to non-separation. The greatest trouble in the world has been caused by duality. The separation that occurs between you and divinity. That is the greatest cause of all problems, duality. When you have two, there is friction. But when there is one, there is no friction. With what can it have friction? You are on the seesaw, going up and down all the time. Pleasure today, pain tomorrow. Pleasure the next day, pain the following day. You're fluctuating. It is your fluctuating that either end. But realize that either ends are but ends of the same one stick. Stand in the center. Reach the center of yourself. Seek ye first the kingdom of heaven within. And that is the center. And from that center, your entire universe radiates. So, we are living in a form of illusion. We find the separation also through attachment. We are too attached to things. Oh, this is my city, this is my house, this is my video, this is my this, my that, me and mine. And forgetting that all this is thee and thine, including me, happening to us. We are being spanked by the stick of our own little mind. Because we lack awareness. As we go deeper and deeper into spiritual practices, you will find your awareness expanding and expanding and expanding until you embrace the entire universe in your arms. And the expansion of awareness is nothing else but the rediscovery of pure consciousness that is there within you all the time, but just veiled. We can use the analogy of a light bulb. You wrap round pieces of cloth around the bulb and don't see the light. But slowly, as you remove the coverings one by one, you come to the naked bulb with all its light, with all its full glory. And you are glorious. If you believe divinity to be glorious and omnipresent, then how can you say that I am not glorious? How can you say, I too am divine? For everyone is divine. But we fail to see that because of separation. And that oneness, that consciousness, pure consciousness or unity consciousness can only come about if you recognize the divinity within yourself first. Like the saying about love. If you cannot love yourself, you cannot love others. It's the same principle. So through these spiritual practices, we discover that inner force. We reach that reservoir of energy. for divinity is energy. You can put on any label you like, it still remains an energy. So the energy is functioning to make you walk, and yet you have the thought that I am walking. Who are you to be able to walk? The energy is moving you. You're not walking. I'm not talking. It's that inner energy that's flowing out. And that people call monism. Well, the Sanskritists would call it Advaita. How can God be separate from you? So, therefore I said in the beginning, is a misconception. And this misconception has come about since childhood, where the parents, the schools, the teachers, it has served a purpose to make you worshipful, to develop faith in you. It has served its purpose, but that is not where it ends. Self-realization begins where religions end. Religions puts you into a groove of thought and you abide by that. But when you go beyond the groove, you see how vast you are, how vast divinity is. And gradually as you proceed, you'd find the entire patterns of your thought changing by itself because of the uncovering of consciousness or developing a greater awareness. You're aware. Who am I? Where did I come from? And why am I here? You've come from nowhere and you're going nowhere. You are the universe itself. And where can this vast universe go to? You're like a bubble in a pond, and the bubble bursts. You're still in the pond. Nothing has been detracted. Not a single ounce of energy can be detracted from this universe, and not a single ounce of energy can be added on. It is a complete whole. And therefore, in order to live holistically, there would be no separation. You've come here to school, to learn, to lessen the burden. And every experience gained has its own particular value. Experience, be it good or bad, it still teaches you something. And that is how your karma, the impressions, the samskaras, are gradually wiped away. Some people can do it in one lifetime. Many might require hundreds of lives. You have come from nowhere and you are going nowhere. Nowhere? Now. Here, by just shifting the letter a bit, the W. Now, here. You are now here. That is all that matters. And if I'm now here, I'm going to enjoy this here-ness, this now-ness to its fullest. If you can really live one moment of your life in its fullest value, you have conquered the entire universe. But people don't do that. It's a world that has only a limited value. It is a relative world. And we view the world from the surface level of our minds. Therefore, we see so much turmoil in the world. But the turmoil we observe around us first starts with the turmoil within us. All kinds of wars, because one reason only. People are warring within themselves with their conflicts. There is this higher force trying to express itself all the time, but you are blocking it by your ego self that is cluttered with all the patternings, all the dirt, and therefore the light does not shine through. We unpattern those patternings, if we clean the windows of that dirty glass, so that light does shine through our minds, lightening it up, through our bodies, lightening the bodies up. You develop a beautiful glow. And the mind becomes kind, compassionate. It assumes the qualities of your higher self. And that higher self is nothing but love. So you allow that infinite love to filter through your mind and bodies, that I've come from nowhere and I'm going nowhere. Shedding this body does not mean you're going anywhere. It is the most important aspect of yourself is the all-pervading spirit, and that spirit can go nowhere because it is all-pervading.